What's up, everyone? It's Chris with the Little Treasury Channel. Welcome back. This is where we bring you awesome watch content at least once a week. And if you haven't already, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to be alerted as soon as we upload. I'm from Little Treasury Jewelers, which is located in Gambrills, Maryland, and it's where you go when you're in the know. As always, the watches that I review are for sale and can be purchased, so please see the description below to contact us. In our last video, we reviewed the Oris Aquis Pro Date Caliber 400, which is another step up for Oris in quality and outside-the-box thinking. I recommend checking this out if you are interested in a larger, very durable dive piece with a sharp design. Today we are doing something different, and on this channel we try to educate you about different types of watches that perhaps you haven't heard of before, or maybe you haven't heard the full story on before. Today I'm bringing a Ball watch onto the channel, and a piece that has been around for many years, but was just recently updated. Today we are reviewing the Ball Engineer Hydrocarbon NEDU. Now let's do a wrist check. Today I'm wearing my Moulet Glacute Pro Mare Go. This one gets the most wrist time of any of my watches because it is pretty casual and understated, and I'm really not afraid to wear it doing most activities. Now, tell me which watch you're wearing and why you enjoy wearing it. Please make sure to not leave out the part of why you are wearing it. I'd really like to know. Now let's get on to the video. Ball was founded in the United States in 1891 by Webb C. Ball, who invented a standard for railroad timekeeping after the Great Kipton train wreck, which involved checks by registered watchmakers on all of the conductors' pocket watches to make sure that the time was not deviating more than 30 seconds per day. If you have ever heard the term on the ball, it is actually in reference to a conductor telling time on his ball pocket watch when asked. Since then, Ball has evolved into a watch company and makes watches with a railroad heritage and vibe. This piece is part of the Engineer Hydrocarbon line, which is Ball's dive series, and this piece in particular is called the NEDU, which, since this watch uses innovative technology, is dedicated to the Navy Experimental Diving Unit, who is responsible for rolling out operational diving and decompression rules. Before we move on, make sure to smash that subscribe button, which is somewhere below where I'm pointing, and support the channel to keep our great content coming week after week for you. Now let's get on to the features. My measurements for the NEDU are a 42.1mm case width, but a 48.1mm if you measure from the crown protector tip, a 16.7mm thickness, a 53.5mm lug to lug, and a 20.5mm lug width, while weighing in at 206.5 grams. The case is made out of titanium and is fully matte finished, besides the stripe of high polish that is on the edges. You will find two star screws on each lug that hold on the bracelet, so keep in mind that if you choose to put an aftermarket strap on this piece, one will have to be removed, leaving an open hole. The pushers are screwed down to prevent accidental presses, but the pushers are safe to use underwater. They have tritium-filled microgas capsules in each, which I will show what that means later on. The screw-down crown is protected by Ball's patented crown protector, which swings open. An interesting innovation from Ball on this piece is a helium escape valve, which is built into the center of the crown. A very clever way to conceal this feature. The bezel has very pronounced industrial-looking bevels and is held in place by four small star-pattern screws. The insert is made out of solid ceramic in blue and has white numerals and a triangle at the 12 position. But really though, how does a Ball bezel sound and feel? I enjoy the bezel action on this piece. It just feels different than the Oris or Grand Seiko or Omega, which I would expect. I will say the action is not super tight, but it is firm enough and it feels very precise. It has a nice noise too, and it's a great balance, and I really like it. The crystal is sapphire and has a bevel around the edges, which provides a fascinating distortion effect. The dial is in a gradient blue and has two tritium capsules at the 12, 3, 6, and 9 markers, and a solid rectangular tritium capsule for the other markers. A 30-minute subdial for the chronograph can be found at the top of the dial, with an all-in-white font besides a red indice at the 30 and 15 minutes. The hand is in silver tone with a red highlight that is lumed but not tritium tubed. A minted grade in white can be found along the edge of the dial, but you will see a red grade from the 0 to 15 minute section. Ball can be found on the right section of the dial with official standard since 1891 in white. Right below this is a day and date window with white background and black numerals, surrounded by a silver frame. Beneath the date, it says chronometer and 600M. The hour and minute hands are in silver tone and are sword style with an open triangular tip and a tritium tube in the center of each. The chronograph second hand has Ball's railroad standard logo at the rear and a tritium tube near the tip. The true second subdial is found at the left area of the dial and has a crosshair in the center in white, with a red grade along the left portion. The hand is silver toned and has a white area at the tip, which is lumed again but not tritium tubed. A 12-hour subdial is found at the lower portion of the watch, which has a white font with red indices at the 12 and 6. Lume can be found on all markers of the bezel and on the hands on the subdials, while 21 micro gas tritium tubes are on the hour, minute, second hands, dial markers, and pushers. If you aren't familiar with tritium, it is radioactive and doesn't need light to glow. It's always glowing and has an operating life of 25 years. While the lumed areas will actually wear out after a few hours, the tritium areas will stay the exact same level of brightness. The case back is closed and you will see a relief of a diver with swords and sharks behind him, which is NEDU's official emblem. The movement is what Ball calls a Ball RR1402-C. It is a modified Valjoux 7750, which has a 42-hour power reserve, beats at 28,800 beats per hour, and is chronometer certified to be between losing 4 and gaining 6 seconds per day. The bracelet is titanium and is a 3-link design with a matte finish on the sides and a high polish area in the center. The buckle, I'm assuming, is steel since Ball says the bracelet is made of titanium and steel. It has another Ball patent, which is a double diver extension, one on each side of the clasp. The Ball Hydrocarbon NEDU is anti-magnetic to 4,800 amp/meters, has a depth rating of 600 meters, and can be yours for a wonderful $4,499. Now for my humble opinion. If you're going to get a Ball watch, this is probably the one to pick up. We have been working with Ball for over 10 years now, and this one has always been around and very popular. It has been redesigned slightly to have an updated bezel and dial, but still all the good features remain. It does look great on my 6.5-inch wrist, although the crown protector can drill into your hand a bit and leave a mark. The weight is not bad at all for how heavy it actually looks. I love the tough industrial look of this piece. It just looks unique and fun. The tritium tubes are really a fun piece of this watch, and you may appreciate them when you wake up in the middle of the night and you can actually read the watch, or while you're driving in your car at night and it really glows, not just a little bit like Lume. The combination of the sharp looks, patented helium valve in the crown, industrial look, chronometer certification, and titanium construction should put this piece on the list for anyone looking for a purposeful dive watch. And the price is actually pretty good too for everything that you get. Thanks for watching today, everyone. I really hope that you enjoyed the video. And if you did, please make sure to smash that subscribe button, give this video a like, and of course, share this with your friends. I look forward to seeing you next video.